Time zone in Thailand is UCT plus 7. So in Thailand, there are two different ways to tell about the time, which are by 24-hour system and by the separated part of a day, which is more commonly used among Thai people. For 24-hour system, there is one word related, which is nalika, 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 which has two different meanings. The first one is o'clock, and another one is a clock or a watch. In this system, a clock is divided into 24 parts, start from 1 o'clock or 1 นาฬิกา, 1 o'clock or 1 นาฬิกา, and ends at 24 o'clock or 24 นาฬิกา, 24 นาฬิกา, which means midnight. Okay, so now let's learn 4 more new vocabulary. The first one is ข้อมือ ข้อมือ means bricks. When it is combined with the word nalika, there is a new word, nalika komu, nalika komu, which means watch. Another word is bluk, bluk, which means to wake someone up, to wake someone up. And then when it is combined with the word nalika, it makes a new word called nalika bluk. Nalika bluk. Can you guess what does this mean? Yes, it means an alarm clock. Now we are going to learn the one is more commonly used, which is the separated part of the day. So it is very commonly used among Thai people. We use this system in our daily conversation. It is used every day. So in this system, time is divided into 5 different parts, and each part has its own words, which are from midnight to 5 a.m. we use the word ti, ti. From 6 a.m. to 11 a.m. we use the word mong chao, mong chao. And then from noon to 3 p.m. we use the word bai, bai. And then from 4 to 6 p.m. we use the word mong yen, mong yen. And the last one from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. we use the word tum, tum. Anyway, what you have seen are just the most commonly used version. For other language course, you might find it different because the time is quite flexible to say, but I believe that you can do it. So let's start with the AM. Start from midnight. Midnight in Thai we say Tiang Kun. Tiang Kun. Tiang means noon. And Kun means night. So Tiang Kun means midnight. And then from 1 a.m. to 5 a.m. the word ti, which means to hit, is used because in the past during these times we leisure will hit a metal for telling the time. So it is ti nung, ti song, ti sam, ti si, and then ti ha. After that, from 6 a.m. to approximately 9 a.m., mong chao is used. Mong chao is used. Chao literally means morning and it is in the brackets, so it can be omitted. So it is hok mong chao, or you can just say hok mong. After that, the word chao is removed because it is already late. And then mong is used until 11 a.m. or 11 โมง11โมง so it is 9โมง10โมง11โมง and additionally โมง is a sound when the gong is hit and here are some example in AM the first one is 7:45 AM in Thai is 7โมงเช้า45นาที7โมงเช้า45นาที or you can just say 7โมง45นาที7โมง45นาที and นาที means minute the second one is 3:30 a.m. which in Thai is ตีสามสามสิบนาทีตีสามสามสิบนาทีนาที can be omitted or there is another way to say which is ตีสามครึ่งตีสามครึ่งครึ่ง means half and the last example 11:34 a.m. in Thai is 11โมง34นาที11โมง34นาที or you can just say 11โมง34 11โมง34 so now we are going to learn more about PM path so start with the word noon in Thai we say เที่ยงเที่ยง or somebody would say เที่ยงวันเที่ยงวัน and then from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. the word บ่าย which means afternoon and โมง is used together so we say บ่ายหนึ่งโมงบ่ายหนึ่งโมง for 1 p.m. บ่ายสองโมงบ่ายสองโมง for 2 p.m.บ่ายสามโมงบ่ายสามโมง for 3 p.m. and for 1 p.m. บ่ายหนึ่งโมง the word หนึ่ง can be skipped so you can say just บ่ายโมงบ่ายโมง and then for 4 p.m. there are two ways to say that the first one is บ่ายสี่โมงบ่ายสี่โมง and the other one is สี่โมงเย็นสี่โมงเย็น and then from 5 to 6 p.m. โมงเย็น is used โมงเย็น so it is ห้าโมงเย็น for 5 p.m. ห้าโมงเย็น and then หกโมงเย็นหกโมงเย็น for 6 p.m. and เย็น in this case meansevening and then from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. the word ทุ่ม is used ทุ่ม is used but the number must start over from 1 again as shown in the box so 7 p.m. is 1ทุ่ม8 p.m. is 2ทุ่ม9 p.m. is 3ทุ่ม10 p.m. is 4ทุ่ม and then 11 p.m. is 5ทุ่ม and here are the example for p.m. the first one 1:56 p.m. in Thai we say บ่ายหนึ่งโมง56นาทีบ่ายหนึ่งโมง56นาที or you can just say บ่ายโมง56บ่ายโมง56 and then 4 p.m. in Thai we say บ่ายสี่โมง or สี่โมงเย็นบ่ายสี่โมง or สี่โมงเย็น and then 4:09 p.m. 4:09 p.m. we say สี่โมงเย็น9นาที4โมงเย็น9นาที so When the minute has only one digit, you need to remain the word nati at the end. Another example, 9:05 p.m. is 3:05 นาที 3:05 นาที So I remain nati. It's not in the blacklist. So you need to say that. And that is another word that I would like to teach you in this chapter, which is ตอน ตอน which means when or at. It is used when you would like to mention about the time or the situation. For example, ตอน 6 โมงเช้า ฉันจะอยู่ที่โรงเรียน ตอน 6 โมงเช้า ฉันจะอยู่ที่โรงเรียน 6 โมงเช้า in this case is time. That's why we use ตอน in front of them. So it literally means at 6 a.m. I will be at school. At 6 a.m. I will be at school. And then the next example. ตอนเธอมาฉันจะไป ตอนเธอมาฉันจะไป เธอมา in this case means she comes. So is it a situation? That's why we use the word ตอน in front of it. So this sentence literally means when she comes, I will go. ตอนเธอมาฉันจะไป When she comes, I will go.